I have started recording.
Oh, you have started. Okay.
Recording will start.
হ্যাঁ বাট নমস্কার যে পার্ট টু স্টার্ট করে দিয়েছে।
হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ
হয়ে গেছে। আচ্ছা হ্যাঁ 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 ঠিক আছে ঠিক আছে।
Okay. Khan sir, am I audible?
Yes, you are audible.
Okay. 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 So, dear students, a very good afternoon to all of you. Respected Rituparno sir, Khan sir, it is my privilege that I have got the opportunity to speak before you regarding the academic regulation. So before going into this, I have already, you all know me in the, but still, let me introduce myself. I am Partho Haldar. I am an assistant professor of mechanical engineering. So I will be teaching you the subjects like engineering drawing, mechanical workshop. Okay. So in the first year, first two semester for all CSE, IT and CT departments, as well as I am holding the position of controller of examinations. So
no, you see that in third semester for CT students, you take some mechanical engineering,
yes,
the basic mechanical engineering and things like thermodynamics and all.
Exactly, sir. For CT students, in the third semester also, I take basic mechanical engineering subject and another thermodynamics paper. Okay. But regarding the academic regulation, I would like to say that few things you should always keep into your mind, that our college is an autonomous institute. So you may have noticed this term autonomous institute after the name of our college. So I would make this session, I would like to make this session a bit interactive. So can anyone tell me what is your idea about this autonomous institute? So do you, I think you must have an idea about before joining this college, okay, the ceramic engineering college is an autonomous college, so let's join there. So what is your belief, what do you understand about autonomous college? Anyone can tell me what is your idea, what? Anyone?
So an autonomous college is a college where the members of the faculty and the teaching members, they control everything that's going on in the college campus.
Like
examinations, the papers are set by the teachers and the regulations, the classes are under your guidance, etc.
So in other colleges also classes will be taken by the teachers of that college only. So where from this college differ from, say, for example, Kollani Government College or Leather Government College of Engineering and Leather Technology. So they are directly under MACOUT. MACOUT means Maulana Abul Kalam Azad University of Technology. So from your point of view, if I say that examination part, the degree, the examination part is controlled by the university. Okay. But in our system, we internally frame the question, we evaluate your answer script, we declare your result, and your degree is being offered by our college in under the obviously under the MACOUT, but jointly we are giving you the degree, okay, the college and the MACOUT. But in case of your other colleges like Kollani and Leather Technology College, the degree is offered by MACOUT only. Okay, so you see, in our college we have revised our academic regulation since 2018-19. Okay, I throughout this session, I will just make you clear about some terminologies also. See, this is academic session. So what is your understanding about the academic session 2018-19? Can anyone tell me what is current academic session? What is current academic session? 21-22.
Now why? Why so?
Anyone? Why so?
Because first semester is continuing from 21, and for the 6 months it will be in 22, and the next 6 months will happen in 22. So therefore, right, the academic session is from 21-22.
Good. So this thing will, if anyone is having any doubt, so this kind of discussion will help you to keep the things in your memory that, okay, this is the case, this is the logic. So see, in the academic year 18-19, we have revised our regulation, and you are, so obviously you are under this academic regulation. So I will be briefing some salient features of this academic regulation under which you will get your degree. Okay, so this is the academic calendar, the course planning. You see, you have 4 years, so 8 semesters. So midterm one, you see, the commencement of course is August. In this pandemic situation, we have shifted to September. Okay, at the mid of September we have started. So the commencement of course is on August 1st week. Then midterm one, this is an examination popularly known as internal one or midterm one. Okay, now next is midterm two, then semester end examination. This is the third, this is, you can say, just like your in your school life, it is almost like your half yearly examination, right? But that is the final one. We are not in annual system, rather we are in semester system. That means 6 months, after 6 months you will have one kind of, you can say, your annual examination, right? So midterm one, midterm two, semester end examination. One semester is completed. Now again, coming to your second semester, that will begin in January, then midterm one in March, midterm two in April, semester end in April, May, and your result is published in July. And this cycle repeats. Okay, you can see that we try to generally the even semester, the second, fourth, sixth, these kind of semester results are generally published in the month of July. But in case of your 8th semester, we try to publish the result in June. Why? Because we try to release our student from the college as early as possible so that they can go for their job as early as possible, right? So they can join their jobs as early as possible. So any doubt up to this? Anyone have any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay.
Sir, can you please repeat the mid examination process?
Okay, I will elaborately discuss those things. But at least you just see this, that there is major three examinations: midterm one, midterm two, and semester end examination. I will discuss about this examination in detail in the next few minutes, within next few minutes, right?
Okay, sir.
Okay, so three examinations are there: major, midterm one, midterm two, and semester end. Okay. Now, before coming to this particular discussion, I would like to show you something that is called your course structure, right? So you can, where from these documents you will get, I am showing you that thing first. You will visit our college website. Okay. It is open to all. if you visit our college website, in your academic section, there is some title called Academic Regulation from 2018-19, and you can see for undergraduate student there is something, some pop-ups are coming. So if you click on this particular field, you will be getting this PDF. This PDF I am discussing, right? So I have informed you about the source from where you can get the material, and now I am discussing about the syllabus. The syllabus of your first year, for CT student, you click this one, first year BTech CT, and for IT, CSE IT student, first year BTech CSE IT. Okay. So after clicking all those fields, you will get these two PDFs. Okay. First year curriculum for BTech course. This is for CSE and IT. You see, Department of CSE and IT. And this PDF is for Department of CT, right? So now, before going into that field, I will discuss about this course structure. This page is your course structure. Let me zoom out a bit. Okay, you see, there are few headings: type of course, course code. Okay, you see, this course code is very important. So this is course code, subject code, paper code. We generally call these name as paper codes or course code. Course title, that means the subject name. Now the credit points. Okay, so you see the major components. There are theory papers, three theory papers: mathematics one, chemistry, and problem for problems, a programming for problem solving. So three papers are there. Okay, under the theory papers, each paper are of how much marks? We know generally, general convention, 100 marks, right? So mathematics one, 100 marks, chemistry 100 marks, programming for problem solving 100 marks. But you see the credits are different, 4, 3, and 3. Okay, now coming to sessional, there are something called sessional, that means laboratory classes. Chemistry lab, here is your theory in chemistry, so chemistry lab. Programming for problem solving, so programming for problem solving lab. And engineering graphics and design, so this particular subject I will teach you. So this is another lab. Okay, so there are 1.5 credit, 2 credit, and 3 credit. Okay, so although these papers are of 100 marks each, but their credit points are different. Because why? You can ask me why. Because it is proportional to the time we are devoting for teaching this particular subject. Depending on the curriculum, you see, for mathematics, theory paper, 3 hours lecture per week, and one tutorial class are needed. So that is why 4 credit points are there. For theory papers, 3 + 1 = 4, 300. If you add them up, it is 3, and here also it is 3. Okay, but it is proportional to the time you are giving for this particular subject. So for chemistry lab, we are having 3 hours in a week. So half. For laboratory classes, the hour you involve in the laboratory class divided by 2, so 1.5. here 2, 4 divided by 2, it is 2, and here you 5 divided by 2, it comes 2.5, but it is 3. Okay, now, so these are laboratory classes. Now coming to another item of your course, that is comprehensive laboratory assessment. So this is a paper that in general you will not find in your routine, in your class routine you will not find this particular subject. Why? Because this is a 100 marks paper which will be evaluated, which will be taken by some external experts after the normal midterm 1, midterm 2 is over, you are about to start your semester end examination, in that time, that means your course is over. You have completed your all laboratory classes, all theory classes, then some external experts will come and they will judge you about your knowledge of these sessional classes. Okay, all together. That means for this particular item, this particular course structure, chemistry expert, programming language expert, and drawing expert, engineering graphics and design expert, external expert will come. They will sit together. You will be giving your viva voce to them and you will be evaluated. So that is another 100 marks paper, and that is having a credit of 1. So total 17.5 credit is there in this first semester of CT department. Similarly, so any doubt up to this? Anyone having any doubt? Theory, sessional, and practical. 3 items are there. Any doubt?
Can you repeat the practical one?
So you be with me. You keep unmuted. You see how many laboratories are there? How many laboratory classes?
3.
What are those?
Basic science course, engineering science course, and
you don't go to this. You just read the names of the subject. Okay, that is chemistry lab,
programming for problem solving lab, engineering graphics.
Yes. And okay, so these will be taught by your subject teacher. Okay.
Yes.
Internal subject teacher, chemistry lab you will be doing under some teacher, programming lab under some teacher, and engineering drawing by myself. So three teachers.
In the sessional and the practical thing, the chemistry lab we will do something like practical things, right? And and practical thing, the comprehensive laboratory assessment, what's the difference between that and the sessional thing?
No, you don't go to these terminologies. Practical, we generally call these as practical classes. So you don't go to these terminologies. You just see how the courses are executed. So obviously in chemistry lab you will be doing some sort of experiments regarding your chemistry class, whatever you have learn in the chemistry theory class, related to those things you will be performing in the lab on hands-on. You will get some hands-on experience, but those will be handled by internal faculties. Now the comprehensive laboratory assessment will be taken by some external experts. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Three external experts will come. They will sit together. You will enter into that particular room. You will give the viva voce to all of the 3 experts, and you will be judged under a marks of 100 under 100 marks. Okay.
So the thing is that we will be teach about this course, right? When the comprehensive laboratory assessment. So it will be teached by the college teachers themselves, right? External teachers.
External experts will come.
Okay. I think so they are getting little bit confused about the thing that you make it clear to them that this chemistry lab, programming, problem solving lab, and then engineering graphics design, these are all falling under the category of sessionals. Because before being sent up for the examinations, these labs are evaluated internally during the classwork. Before being admitted for the examination, these labs are evaluated by the internal teachers on 100 marks basis, and these marks are sent to the central section for preparation of admit cards. If someone does not attend the chemistry class or programming lab class or engineering graphics design lab class regularly, there is lack of attendances, lack of initiatives in the practicals, And if the teacher feels that the student has not performed the laboratories well enough, then he may fail in the examination session. And his
yes.
marks would not be sent to the controller section for preparation of admit card. So that means
yes, he
is not liable to sit in the examination at all. That means he has to repeat all the courses. That means if he fails in the sessional, he is not at all entitled for.
Yes, sir. Sir, hello.
Sir, you are not able.
I think he has some problem. Professor Sen has some problem. Is we can't hear his voice.
Okay. Basically, I will inform about this rule. But before that, see here we have. This is the regulation document. Here we have theory, sessional, and practical. So what are those?
So I'm interrupting. Oi. যে ল্যাব গুলো ওগুলোতে কন্টিনিউয়াস ইভালুয়েশনটা বলে দাও তাহলে ওরা বুঝতে পারবে
হ্যাঁ বলে দিচ্ছি
হ্যাঁ আমার পাওয়ার ফেলিয়ার হয়ে গিয়েছিল পাচ্ছো পাওয়ার ফেলিয়ার হয়ে গিয়েছিল বলে কেটে গেল ড্রপ করে আমি আবার ইয়ে দিয়ে এটা জয়েন করলাম জানি না কতক্ষণ স্টেবল হবে
না না বেশি কোন ফেল হয়নি
এইটা বুঝতে
পারছি ঠিক আছে
বেশি কোন ফেল হয়নি
আমি স্যার
হ্যাঁ ইউ আর ক্লিয়ার
ইয়েস স্যার
হ্যাঁ এইটা বলে দিস হ্যাজ টু বি মেড ক্লিয়ার দ্যাট ইফ দে ডোন্ট পাস ইন্টারনালি ইন দিস ল্যাবরেটরি সেশনালস দেন দে আর নট গোইং টু পার্টিসিপেট দে আর নট অ্যাডমিটেড ফর দি এক্সামিনেশন অলসো
ইয়েস স্যার আই এম ইন দি ল্যাবরেটরি সেশনালস
Yeah.
Yes, sir. I am going to tell them about these rules. But before that, see here in the academic regulation, that terminologies are there. So to make them familiar, I have planned that before going into these theory, sessional, and practical terms, they should know what are those things. Well, basically, theory is this kind of subject. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. So now it is Rudrayan and everyone, it is clear how the comprehensive laboratory assessment, what is this paper and how it will be evaluated?
Yes, sir. Now coming
back to the rule that sir was, yes, ask me.
I can understand the credit scorecard, where it will be used in the examination.
I will discuss that. But before this, now it's time to know the rules and regulations. Okay, I will discuss these credit points will be very much important to evaluate the marks, to evaluate the result of yours. Okay, but before that, you should know the rules and regulations to sit for the examination. Okay. So here you see three items: theory, sessional, and practical. Okay. Now you see two midterms. I have already told you two midterms and one semester end examination. Right? Okay. Back paper means supplementary examinations. Say for example, you have not passed. This is applicable for only theory papers. And that comprehensive laboratory assessment, we call it CLA. That this CLA, comprehensive laboratory assessment, in short, we call it CLA. Okay. So this back paper concept is only applicable for theory papers and CLA. If you fail in any of the sessionals. That means the laboratory classes, you will not be eligible to sit for the theory examinations, theory semester end examination. Okay. Listen carefully. You will, in normal course, you will be having your class routine. You will be having your all the six classes, three theory papers, three sessional papers. Okay. You will be having this throughout your say 4 months course or 5 months course. But if you fail in any of these three papers, chemistry lab, programming lab or engineering graphics lab, you will not be able to sit for the semester end examination of these theory papers as well as this CLA paper. Okay. So, but back paper, the concept of back paper means the concept of back paper comes when you are eligible for appear for the theory paper examination. That means you have passed this lab papers, okay, and now you are getting your admit card, you are sitting for your theory paper examinations, your CLA examinations, but you are unable to clear that particular theory paper, then in the next year you will be promoted to the higher class, but in the next year with your junior batch you will be appearing with your junior batch for these theory papers. Say for example you have passed all your sessional paper, you have got your admit card, you are appearing for the all these theory paper and CLA, but unfortunately you have failed in mathematics one this year, this semester. So you will be promoted to second semester. In second semester, no issue, you have passed with flying colors, you are promoted to third semester. When you are in third semester, your junior one batch will come. With those student, you will be appearing the mathematics one in the end semester examination. So this is the concept of back paper. So this is a case you all should try to avoid. You should not try to obtain any back paper or so. You should always try to get good marks. So let's talk to the normal thing. So back paper is we don't wish to have, obviously. So you see, again I am coming to this, you have two midterm test, one semester end examination. Now how these theory papers are evaluated, you see the evaluation process for each theory items 100 marks are there, 100 marks, okay. Now how these 100 marks are evaluated, as I have told you, there are two midterm 1 midterm 2. So those two midterms, let's come to this table. Okay, see, theory papers are having 100 marks, midterm 1 15 marks, midterm 2 15 marks, and throughout your class, theory classes, you will be given assignments, you will be tested on quiz, surprise test, presentation, attendance. Based on this thing, the internal faculty member, the faculty will evaluate under 20 marks. Okay, so how much coming as an internal continuous internal evaluation? 15 marks from midterm 1, 15 marks from midterm 2, and continuous assessment 20. So 50 marks, right? Now in the semester end examination, you will have a question paper of 75 marks, but that 75 marks will be converted into 50 marks. So thus, after joining all these components, you will be having 100 marks. You got my point? In the semester end examination, you will appear the examination of 75 marks, but that will be converted into a scale of 50 marks. 75 multiplied by 2/3, you will get the marks out of 50, and that will be added with all these three internal marks, and then you will be getting one marks out of 100. Is there any doubt regarding the evaluation of theory items?
No, sir. Sir.
No, sir.
In the semester end examination, you will have a question paper of 75 marks, as simple as this. Say for example, you have obtained 60 out of 75. Okay, so 60 okay. Out of 75 means into 2/3, that means 40 marks will be taken from there, and from these above three components. Say, for example, you have got another 40. So you will get total 80 marks, 40 plus 40, 80 marks out of that for that particular theory paper. Any doubt?
Okay. No, sir.
Sir, what will be the full marks for the midterm examinations?
15. 15 marks, 15 for midterm 1, 15 for midterm 2, and 20 marks. This will be judged by your class teacher during the classes. You will be given assignments, you will be having quizzes, surprise tests, presentation, attendance. The teacher will, throughout the class, will look up, will judge you in each and every class. So, you will be evaluated under 20 marks from there. So you have to be very, very cautious from the very first day. Say, for example, if we have made the compulsory report writing for this induction program, but if it would be a theory class, in the very first, from the very first day, I will take attendances. So see, at present, how many students are attending this session? How many? Say 80 or something. So 40 students are absent. Okay. So those
93.
Okay. So those who are absent today, they will lose marks automatically, because there are marks with attendance, right? You are losing every marks in single day. If you are serious enough, if you are attending all classes, you will get marks, right? So you have to be very serious from the very first day. Okay. Now, coming to the evaluation of 100 marks. 100 marks, coming to the evaluation of sessional paper or laboratory or practical paper. Okay, laboratory class. That is the not practical, sessional or laboratory class. So as RS sir was pointing that is a 100 marks subject, and you will be evaluated under 100 marks by the concerned subject teacher. Okay, so laboratory journal book preparation and result 40 marks, Viva Voce conducted by the internal faculty. All these things will be done by the internal faculty, and attendance, overall conduct, discipline, manners 20 marks. So this will be told by your subject teacher in detail in the beginning of the class, and you will be having 100 marks paper, and you will be judged by out of 100 marks altogether. So no extra division like midterm 1, midterm 2, or continuous evaluation, semester end examination, like the theory paper. These are not there in the case of sessional paper. Okay, you will be judged out of 100 marks, and that marks division will be discussed by the concerned internal faculty member at the beginning of the class. That okay, I am teaching your engineering graphics and design, so this is an 100 marks, this is a 100 marks paper, and I will evaluate you according to this parameter, and I will describe that thing in the beginning of the class. Is there any doubt?
No, sir.
Now one major question comes, that what is the pass marks? For each and every item, the pass marks is 50. You have to obtain minimum 50 marks out of these 100 for getting passed. Okay. So pass marks is 50 altogether. Out of 100, you have to secure at least 50 marks to getting passed. Right, for yes, each sir. And every paper. Okay, sir. Anything, sir, you wish to add, RS sir or Khan sir? Now,
no, you're okay. You continue.
Okay, now coming to the
only tell them how the CLA is held, means how the CLA is held.
Okay, I have externals. Yes, sir. I have already informed that. Okay, now coming to other criterias. You see, a student has to secure at least 50% in total, combining continuous internal examination and semester end examination. Okay, but you should always keep in mind that, say, for example, if you are very good in your subject and you have obtained, say for example, you have obtained 50 out of 50 in the internal examination. See, you can obtain 15 out of 15 in midterm one, right? You can obtain 15 out of 15 in midterm two, and you are very good at your classwork, you may obtain 20 out of 20 also. So in total you are getting 50, but you are not appearing in the semester end examination. You are not appearing in the semester end examination. What will happen? Will you be passed? No. The answer is no. A candidate not appearing in the semester end examination would, however, be considered unsuccessful in the concerned subject, because you have to sit for that semester end examination at least. You may secure zero, but you have to appear for that semester end examination. Otherwise, you will get backlog in that paper. Right?
Yes, sir.
So this is clearly written in our academic guideline. So semester end examination is a very, very vital examination. You have to appear for that examination at any cost to get pass. Okay, now coming to other things, other important things. Here you see the pass marks, 50%. Each item is 50%, sessional also, theory paper, sessional, laboratory, practical, whatever is the paper is 50%. Now coming to the situation where you may get year lag. Okay, let me tell you, say for example, you have nothing due in your first semester. You have cleared all the things in your first semester, okay? Okay, let me tell you, okay. Say for example, you have passed in your, you are doing your regular class and you have failed. Okay, oh, it is behaving abruptly. Okay, say for example, you are doing your regular class, but unfortunately you are unable to manage pass marks in any of this sessional paper. What will happen? You will not be able to sit for the semester end examination. Basically, you will be having year lag. If you fail in any of the sessional paper, you will be having year lag in the first semester. If you have failed in, say for example, any of the paper, you have to wait for another 1 year, then your junior batch will come, you can take readmission to the college. Okay, you will be having year lag. Say for example, you have cleared all the subjects of first semester, you have promoted to the second semester. Okay, that means you are studying this particular course now, second semester. This is the course structure of second semester. Now you have failed in any of the sessional item over here, then also you will be having year lag. Okay, you will wait for few months, your new batch will come, you will take readmission, you will continue with them as a fresher. Okay, so sessional item is very, very important. Every items are important. Sessional items are very, very important because you will not get any chance to clear it later on. If you fail in theory papers, if you fail in the practical examination, you will get the CLA item, you will get another chance to sit for the examination as a back paper, as a supplementary paper. But if you fail in these laboratory classes or sessional items, you will get an year lag. And this is applicable to all of your higher semesters. If you fail in the third semester, you will be rejoining with your junior batch in the third semester. If you fail in the fourth semester, you will be joining your next batch in third semester again. Okay. Is there any doubt?
Clear, sir.
So very much clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. So this thing is written in this point number 6, 7, and 8. Okay. You have to repeat all the courses of relevant odd and even semester. If you fail in the second semester also, then also you will rejoin the first semester, odd semester also. Okay. And here in the next academic session, simple, as I have mentioned. Okay. Now coming to the CLA, how it will be conducted. A board of external expert will come. I have already told you. Okay. So in your result sheet, if you are obtaining P, that means you are promoted. If you are having XP, that means you are promoted with some backlog. You have some backlog in your theory papers, because in case of practical, in case of laboratory or sessional, you have no chance. You will get simply X means year lag. You are not promoted. Okay. XP means that indicates you are having some lag in your theory paper or in CLA. Okay. P means promoted to next level without any backlog. XP means promoted to next level with backlog in subjects of examination, and X means not promoted. Okay. Either being debarred in semester end examination due to failure in sessional item. See, it is clearly written here. Okay. Now coming to another important Khan sir, how much time I am eligible to talk? Khan sir?
It is 3:22 now.
How much time I can take more?
Well, your time slot ends in 2:30.
3:30, okay.
I'm sorry, 3:30.
Okay. Another 10 minutes maximum. Okay, sir.
Yes.
Okay. See, now I hope up to this I have cleared everything. Now coming to this particular point, see, Alok sir, in the next session we will be discussing about this particular point elaborately, but what I can tell you in brief, that say for example, in which degree you are reading BTech in CT ceramic technology, BTech in CSE, BTech in IT, but if you wish to obtain BTech with honors in your degree certificate, this term will come. You have passed BTech with honors from GCCT under Makaout and all. So BTech with honors, if you wish to have this particular term in your degree certificate, then you have to obtain 20 additional credits. And how these credits can be obtained? In the first year, you have to obtain 8 credits. In the second year, 4. Third year, 4 credits. And fourth year, 4 credits. And how these credits can be earned, this will be discussed elaborately by Alok sir. So wait for the next session. Now, coming to the evaluation, the result preparation section. Okay. In the result preparation section, you see. So ultimately, you are having all the papers out of 100 marks, right? So if you score between 90 to 100, you will get O, grade O, outstanding. Similarly, 89 to 80, E, excellent, and so on. A, B, C, and below 50, it is F. Okay. Now, here comes the roles of the credit from the core structure. One student asked me that what are these credit points? Now, here comes the role of these credit points. Say for example, any student is obtaining 95 in this mathematics. Okay, how much grade he will get? O. Okay, that means he will, you see, credit is 4. For mathematics, the credit is 4. That will be multiplied by 10 because he has obtained 95. That means in this slab. Okay. So 10 multiplied by 4, that means 40 credit points he will earn. Similarly, he has managed O again in chemistry. So 90 to 100 marks slab. So again, he will get another 30 credit points. 3 multiplied by 10 again. Okay. In the problem solving, again he has got O, 3 multiplied by 10. So 30. Okay. So thus, if a student manages O in every single subject, so that means his total credit point will be 175. Yes or no? 10 multiplied by all these credit points? Yes. So in this particular first semester, you all are competing for these 175 credit points. 17.5 multiplied by 10. But will it happen for all? সবাই কি 10 এ 10 মানে 10 করে পাবে? Practical sense says no. So there may be difference in the credit point obtained. So out of 175 credit points, one may get 175, one may get 170, one may get 165, and so on. Okay. So in your result, you will see that you are getting one SGPA. SGPA means semester grade point average. You will be having SGPA. Let me write it. SGPA, semester grade point average. Okay. So what this indicates? This indicates, say for example, you have managed 160 out of 175. So maximum 175 you can earn. So basically 160 you have earned, that is divided by your total credit of that particular semester. So you will be having how much? 160 divided by 17.5. So 9.14, approximation up to the 2 decimal place. 9.14 you will get in your as your SGPA 1, as your SGPA 1, right? And this is also in our current system, this is also CGPA 1, 9.14. What is this CGPA stands for? This CGPA is for cumulative grade point average. Okay. Now you have promoted to second semester, right? You see the course curriculum of second semester. In your second semester, how much credits are there? There are total of 20.5 credits. That means you will have a maximum chance to obtain how much? 20.5 means 205 credit points total. 20.5 multiplied by 10, so 205, right? 205 you can maximum obtain. Say for example you have obtained 190, so what will be your SGPA? 190 divided by 20.5, so approximation up to 2 decimal place, 9.27. so 9.27 will be your SGPA 2. Any doubt up to this?
No. Now
coming to the role of CGPA 2, how much will be your cumulative grade point average? Your CGPA 2 will be the credit point you have earned till semester 2. That means 160 plus 190 divided by 17.5 plus 20.5. That is equal to 160 plus 190, 350 divided by how much? 38. Up to 2 decimal approximation, 9.12. 9.12. 21 koto chilo? 9.21. So this will be your CGPA 2. And similarly, when you will be appearing for CGPA 8, that will be the whole credit points you have earned till your from your first semester to the eighth semester divided by the total credit of the BTech course. 17.5 plus 20.5 plus another say 23 plus 25 and so on. মানে যত করে থাকবে সেই total creditটা divide হয়ে you will get the ultimate CGPA 8 and that will be your final CGPA. Any doubt how these credits are coming into play for evaluating your answers, your results and grade cards? Any doubt?
Yes.
And two more things I have told in detail how the results is prepared and all. So now I wish to add two more things. Okay, one of the major criteria, what are the major criteria to sit for the examination? So all these calculation details are written here. I have already given examples, so you can, once you will go through this, everything will be clear to you. And this is in public domain, so you can read this thing.
Where have you sent this slides?
So these are not slides. These are documents available in the college website. Okay, but I wish to tell you two more things. What is the eligibility for attending the examination? One of the major eligibility criteria is this one. Every department, each and every department sends the controller of examinations. That means at present time to me, department sends me the attendance report of every individual of every classes. He or she has to attend at least 75 of the theory class and 75 of the practical classes separately. Okay. If you fail to attend the classes 75% at least, then you will not be eligible to sit for the examination. So from the very first day, you should be very cautious to attending the classes, because if there is, say for example, if there is only 5 class in that, say it does not happen. Say for example, if there is only 20 class of any particular subject in the semester and you miss 10, that means you are attending only 50% of the class. That means you are not eligible to sit for the examination. So attendance is very, very important criteria. From the very first day, you should keep in your mind. Okay, so every department, every subject teacher sends me the report of attendance of every individual, then only admit card is generated for the semester end examination. Okay, so this is one of the major criteria, as well as I have already told that you should not have any backlog. You should not have failed in the sessional items. If you fail in the sessional, then you will be having your year lag. Here also same case. If you fail to comply this criteria, you will be having year lag ultimately. Okay, but
sir, I have a question.
Yes,
sir. You have told that if I I got XP in any in any examination result, and right. What will happen then? You told that if I get XP, it means that I passed but with some backlogs. Then what right. will happen?
In the that means you have failed in any of the theory papers, right, Aniruddha?
Yeah.
Okay, so in the next batch, when you will be in the third semester, say for example, this has happened in your first semester. So when you will be in the third semester, then some new students will come, join the college. You are in the third semester, you are pursuing your normal course.
Yeah.
You will be sitting for the semester end examination with those first year students. Say, for example, in mathematics. Okay. So you will be appearing for the mathematics semester end paper with the junior students, and you will obtain certain marks. Okay. Now, okay. I think you wish to know how the marks will be evaluated, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. See, that is something I should take help of this board. Say, for example, when you are in normal, your regular first semester, I am, please don't mind, Aniruddha, I am taking your name just for example, okay? Say,
yeah,
for example, in midterm one, you have got 10, okay? In midterm one. In midterm two, you have got 5. And in continuous assessment, you have got 10, okay? And in the semester end, out of 75, you have got, say, for example, you have got 50. So that is multiplied by 2/3. How much it will be? 133. In that case, you are passing. Okay. Let it be 30. You have got, say, for example, in the semester end examination, you have got 30.
Okay.
So 2/3, that means you are getting
20
how much? 20 marks from the semester end. So how much in total you are getting?
45, yeah.
Which is less than 50. That means you are having backlog in that particular mathematics paper, right?
Yeah.
Now in the next third semester, you are not eligible to sit for this thing. You have no option to correct this thing because you are pursuing your third semester course. So you have no time to sit for these midterm one, midterm two, and class, normal regular class. So you are not eligible to sit for this. Only chance you have to improve this score, that is semester end course. Say, for example, now you have managed to obtain 60, right?
Okay.
So this 60 will be converted 2/3. So how much it is? 40.
40.
This 40 will be added. This 40 will be added with your old internal marks. That means 40 plus 10 plus 10, 60 plus 5, 65.
65.
Okay.
Yeah.
You may no. This is not the case. This is one component. This is one case. 65. This is marks A. Say, for example, this is marks A. Okay. Just like the previous method. You have appeared for the semester end examination, you have got 60 multiplied by 2/3, so 40 plus the old internal marks, that means 65. This is marks A. And another marks will come. That is, you have obtained 60, right? So 60 will be scaled to 100 marks. 100 marks means out of 75, you have got 60. So out of 75 divided by 60 divided by 75, that will be converted into 100. So multiplied by 4/3. This 60 marks will be converted to 100 scale. That means you are having how much?
80 marks. Yeah.
This is marks B. This is marks B. Now, whichever is more. 65 or 80, whichever is more.
Yeah, 80. Obviously 80.
So this will be your final mark if you appear for the backlog examination.
Okay.
Any doubt? Anyone?
No. No, sir. Thank you.
Backlog ho lo, but if the third semester exam collapses with that exam, then?
No. We will take care about the routine.
Okay.
Maximum what can happen, obviously in one slot, this thing will not club. Maximum thing what can happen, you have to appear for two semester end examination in a single day. Okay. Generally, we keep one semester end examination in one day and another day gap. But maximum, in worst case, what may happen, you are appearing for your normal paper in first half and the backlog paper in the second half. We will take about that thing in the routine while framing the routine. Okay.
Okay.
So I have covered all the major concerns, all the major points of this academic regulation, I believe, but there are very important points also. See, what if you do any malpractice during the examination, how you will be punished, everything, every details are given here, but it is not the platform, it is not the desirable thing that we wish to have from your side. I hope you will not take any of the malpractice methods, because you are all are serious students. So I hope this kind of punishment kind of thing, I at least we never wish to enforce on you. So this is the hope. With this hope, I wish to end my session. And still, if you have any doubt, you can ask me. And thank you for your patient learning. And you, request to RS sir, if I have missed anything, sir, RS sir or Khan sir,
you are quite clear. The time was very short.
Okay.
And you could have gone on, but now I have to turn it on to Alok.
Is RS sir there?
RS sir should be there.
Sir, page number 3.
Yes, sir is there. Yes, somebody has.
Okay. Huh. Yes. What you are asking, dear student?
Sir, page number 3. There. One written that if anyone fails to give midterm exam, then can you explain that paragraph? Yeah. Page number 3, second point.
Page number 3. Under 3.
Yes, yes.
What is the bullet number?
3.
Wait. Let me see at the screen. Which one?
The second point, sir. If a student fails to appear.
Where?
Up. Atu Nama? A point.
This case, right?
Yes, sir, yes.
See, if a student fails in midterm examination, then he or she will be allowed to sit for the special test if and only if the exam committee is satisfied with his or her prayer for such prayer. So what will happen? Say, for example, you have not appeared in midterm 1 due to some reason. You will appeal to the principal, who is the chief controller of the institute. Okay, the principal will place the prayer to the exam committee. Okay, principal sir has now requested the exam committee to decide whether your reason is justified to allow you to sit for special test or not. If the exam committee satisfied, then you will be given a chance to sit for special test. Otherwise, you will get 0. Right?
Okay, sir. It means if a student fails to appear, means if he doesn't appear for the test.
Yes. Due to some reason.
Okay.
Fails to appear means he has not joined on that day, basically. Okay. He was unable to attend the college on that particular day of examination.
Say, for example, God forbid, you may be sick.
Hmm.
You have to give your medical certificate for that case.
Hmm. But with your clear, the exam committee should be satisfied. Otherwise, you will not be eligible to sit for the examination. Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. So anything more? খান স্যার সবকিছু কভার করেছি তো
হ্যাঁ সবই প্রায় কভার হয়ে গেছে এবার অলককে
অ্যাটেনডেন্স অ্যাটেনডেন্স তো হয়েছে ক্রাইটেরিয়া ছিল সেটা বলেছি
হ্যাঁ মার্কস কি করে ক্যালকুলেশন হয় সেটাও বলেছো পরীক্ষার স্যার ইয়েগুলোও বলেছো এরপরে ওরা ওই কি বলে আমাদের ওয়েবসাইট থেকে দেখে যদি কোনো কোশ্চেন হয় তখন তোমাকে আলাদা করে জিজ্ঞেস করতে পারে এর অলককে বলবো অলক শুনতে পাচ্ছো হ্যাঁ তুমি জয়েন করো অলক না প্রফেসর অলক মুখার্জি উইল টেল ইউ অন মুকস
ওকে সো গুড আফটারনুন টু অল মাই সিনিয়র্স অল মাই কলিগস এন্ড ইয়ার স্টুডেন্টস এন্ড বিফোর স্টার্টিং দ্য লেকচার আই উইল স্পেশালি রিকোয়েস্ট
অলক একটু মাইকটা জোরে করবে একদম শোনা যাচ্ছে না খুব আস্তে
ওকে আই উইল স্পেশালি রিকোয়েস্ট খান স্যার আর এস স্যার And especially to our controller Partha sir, that if I miss any point regarding this MOOCs, I will give a presentation on that. So if I miss any points, please, especially to Partha. So if I miss any point, please let me confirm that point and interrupt me and add to the point. Okay. So I will share the screen with you. Just a minute. Actually, the weather is very bad out here, so I don't know. There might be a network issue or something, but the weather is absolutely bad out here.
Yeah, it's raining very much.
It's raining very much, and I also had some while to Partho's lecture. Don't know. Is the screen visible?
Yes, yes, yes.
Yes, yes, it's visible.
Okay. I will give a short, very short presentation. Partho sir has already described very elaborately about the academic regulation and all. And a very small portion of that is regarding the MOOCs, that is the online teaching platform, which is necessary for attaining the honors degree along with BTEC. For BTEC, you all know that 8-semester course is mandatory. You have to pass all the subjects, theory, as well as sessional papers and all. So that is for BTEC. And if you want honors along with BTEC, then you have to go for this MOOC courses. Okay, Partho sir has already told you all this. So I will just give you a brief introduction to what is that and how to obtain that credit points of 20 additional credit points and all this in this presentation. So first of all, what is MOOC? Now, MOOC is Massive Open Online Course. That is the full form of MOOCs. Okay, that is Massive Open Online Course. You can understand the illustration of each of the words. It is an open source, that is anyone can take these courses online because it is completely on online basis only. You have to go for a final examination at the end of the course. I will explain that. And massive means there are a lot of students and all this. So you can understand several university colleges, everything is associated while organizing this MOOCs and all these things. So it is an online test. Definitely there will be an online test, research based things, e-learning is there, different webinars are there. So I will straight away go to the basic part of the MOOCs. So it is a kind of additional teaching to your class teaching. This is the basic objective of MOOCs. That is, whatever you are learning in your class during the 8-semester courses, apart from that, if you want some extra knowledge to add, then you have to go for this MOOC courses. Okay. So all these things actually had started while there were distance learning. Distance learning program, you are, many of you are already aware of. Correspondence course where the poster system were there, that is several notes, documents were coming through this postal system. That is the early stage of this online platform. After this digital age, all these distant learning courses were compiled into an e-learning portal. That means if you have an internet system, then by logging into some portal, you can gather some knowledge, and that knowledge is additional to the 8-semester course knowledge. Now remember one thing, that 8-semester course is the most essential for you to get the BTEC degree. You have to do that. In addition to that, if you want honors degree, as Partho sir have already told you, If you want that honors degree, then these courses are required. Okay. So I will not describe the history of MOOCs and all these things. So I will just tell you that what is the basic structure of MOOCs. Okay. What are there in the MOOCs? You can understand that you are learning something additional. Suppose one subject you are learning from this online portal. So definitely some lecture notes will be there. Some handouts will be there. And nowadays, due to this online platform, some video lectures are also there. Normally, I will tell you that IITs, IISCs, they already conduct these MOOCs. There are different other platforms and all that. But in this institution, we follow the courses given by NPTEL. Okay, I will discuss that. So some eminent professors, they put up some video lectures. That is their class teachings and all. These are also given along with the lecture notes. So in the lecture notes, you have the handouts, the printed copies, the lectures are already given in the form of book. Along with that, there are some video lectures of class teaching recording as well as some additional teaching recordings, so that you can go through the handouts. And if you feel any difficulty or if you want to know the illustrations, you can also refer to the video lectures. Those are already available in that online portal. I will show you. So you can relate to the books or the lecture notes with the video lectures, what the teachers are saying. This is just like an online class. Many of you are already aware of that, but those who are not aware of that, especially for those I'm telling you, that you see the video lectures and take the after you see the video lecture, just as you do in the class, that is you attend the class, you listen to what sir is saying or madam is saying. Then when you go home, just go through what you have already noted down in your copies or what teacher has already given you as handout. So you go through those and try to relate what teacher has said with those handouts. Okay. And you grasp the knowledge inside you. Okay. This is very much similar to that. But only thing is that these are all happening in online using internet portal. And after this learning is complete, then definitely there is a question of evaluation. So there should be some problem sets, assignments. So these will be given to you. You have to submit those assignments all online. You have to submit those assignments online. And you will be evaluated based on the answers you have given in that assignment. And after this assignment part is complete, that is learning is complete, there is an end semester examination. Just like your semester examination is there, there is also a final examination, which you have to go to some institute and write the examination online. I will tell you all this. So these are all the basic structure of any kind of MOOC. Okay. So as I have told you that there are different platforms of MOOC. But here, what we prefer is the courses offered by NPTEL, which is presently under the SWAM portal. Okay, I will tell you this. Now, they offer several courses. Many of you are already acquainted with this NPTEL portal or SWAM portal. So for them, this is nothing new. But for those who are not aware of these things, I will tell you that SWAM is an authority which offers several courses, out of which some courses will be offered to you by the institute. We will assign actually different HODs. Partho sir is the controller. All of them sit together and decide about some courses that this will be offered to this semester students. This will be offered to this semester students like that. Okay. So you have to take that. Okay. Before that, going to those details, I can tell you that this NPTEL courses are available everywhere in the world. So these are quite universal courses, and this is primarily intended for education for all and sustainable development and all this. These are the benefits of this online courses. Probably you are all aware of that. That is, anyone sitting to a very remote place, the very remote village, just only having some internet connection can access all this online courses. So this is the basic goal of this basic benefit of this online tutorial. That is education for all, even who cannot reach the actual institute to get the courses done there. Okay, so they can do the courses sitting at their home at a very remote place with the help of internet. Okay, Now I'm coming to your perspective, that is from student's perspective, that is, why should you do these courses? Partho sir has already explained to you, just I'm adding something. That is, the basic objective is, the obvious answer is this: adding knowledge beyond your books. Whatever you are learning in books, in your curriculum, 8-semester curriculum, beyond that, if you want to add something to your knowledge, definitely these courses are very much required. Okay. Now, anything else? Is there anything else that bothers you to take these courses or compels you to take these courses? Then I should add something. Better, many of you are asking in mind that are these included in the syllabus or are this compulsory? Now, the answer I should give that it is quite so. That is, clearly, in clear terms, if I should say that it is like adding some honors to your degree, that Pastor Sahib has already told you, that is to get the BTEC with honors. According to AICT guidelines 2019, now students need to earn additional 20 credit points that Partho Sahib has already showed you, displayed you in the academic regulation, that additional 20 credit points are required to be collected from this MOOCs, okay, to achieve BTEC with honors. Only that. Now, I am again clearing this thing to you, that if you want only BTEC, you may skip these courses. But if you want BTEC with honors, that honors degree can only be achieved if you complete these 20 credit points from this MOOC courses. Be very clear about it. Only for BTEC, no such courses are required. But if you want BTEC with honors, then definitely you have to earn this 20 credits only from this online portal. There is no other options. Okay, only using this online tutorials, you have to earn 20 credit points through this MOOCs. Okay, now I am coming to how to attain this. As sir has already told you, that this 20 credit points are divided in 4 years. Okay, now each MOOC, I should stress here, each MOOC, that is 12-week or 8-week duration, that is minimum 8-week duration course you have to take. Which courses you need to take, I will tell you, but minimum 8-week duration course you require, 8 or 12-week course. Each course in this institution will carry 4 points. As I have already told you, that this is an autonomous institution, this ceramic college is an autonomous institution, so each course we are assigning 4 credit points. So that means to earn 20 credit points, you need to complete 5 courses. That is 5 into 4 = 5 courses you need to complete within your 4 years of curriculum. Okay. Now, for your convenience, this 20 points are distributed in this way. 8 points. That is 2 courses are given or allotted for first year. First year means including first and second semester. And 4 points each for the remaining 3 years. That is for second year 1 course, third year 1 course, final year 1 course. And that 1 course can be completed either in the odd semester or in the even semester. That is, for example, someone is studying in semester 3, he or she can complete the course in the third semester as well as in the fourth semester, whichever he or she wants. Okay, similarly for the third year course, he or she can complete the course by fifth semester or sixth semester, similarly for final year as well. But for the first year, you have to complete 2 courses. Okay, someone can do the course in first semester, both the courses in first semester. Someone can complete both the courses in the second semester. Someone can also take up 1 course from the first semester, 1 course from the second semester, but you have to complete the course. Okay, this is a general guideline. That is, if someone says, remember this, listen to this very carefully now, whatever I am telling you, listen to this very, very carefully and keep these points in your mind, okay? That five courses you need to complete. Now, we will give several options. Suppose in the second year, first year, suppose someone has completed two courses. In the second year, and he or she in the third semester, every department offers a bunch of four or five courses, optional. That is four or five options we are giving, out of which you have to take only one course. Suppose you are in third semester, I'm talking about. So in third semester, you are now presently in third semester, you are given a notice that for this second year, third semester course, there are five courses, out of which you have to take one. Now you have already completed two courses in the first year. Now you are pending with three more courses for second, third, and final years. Now, if someone wishes that in this second year, I will complete all the three courses, so my five courses will be done, this will not be entertained. Remember this very carefully. The rule is that you have to take two courses from first year and one course each from each year. That is second year, you have to complete one course. Third year, you have to complete one course. And final year, you have to complete the last course, final course. So no deviation from this will be allowed. Bolo, is there any doubts from you up to this? Anyone has any doubt up to this, what I have talked?
No, sir.
Okay.
I have a question.
All right. So, bolo.
Haan, sir, bolchi ei somosto course gulo shongeo ki normally assignment ba ei somosto jinish gulo ache?
Ha, obosshoi. Seta ami tomader details e ami bole debo.
Okay, sir. Mane normally semester wise je course gulo amra korchi tader te assignment submit korte hocche.
আমি সেখানে বলে দেবো এই কোর্স গুলোতে ডিটেলে কি কি করতে হয়। ওকে
ওকে
স্যার। আর স্যার কোর্স গুলো স্টুডেন্টরা নিজের ইচ্ছামতো চুজ করতে হবে, তাইতো?
না, ইচ্ছামতো চুজ করতে পারবে না। এখনই যেটা বললাম যে তোমাদের প্রত্যেক সেমিস্টারে একটা বাঞ্চ অফ কোর্স তোমাদের দিয়ে দেওয়া হবে ফর ইচ স্ট্রিম। সিটির জন্য একটা বাঞ্চ, আইটির জন্য একটা বাঞ্চ, সিএসসির জন্য একটা বাঞ্চ, মানে বাঞ্চ অফ ফোর অফ ফাইভ কোর্সেস উইল বি গিভেন টু ইউ। দোজ উইল বি ডিক্টেড বাই দা কনস এইচওডিস এন্ড কন্ট্রোলার স্যার। ওকে, তারা, কারণ এনপিটিএল এর এই কোর্সগুলো দেয়ার এন্ড ম্যাসিভ নাম্বার অফ কোর্সেস, থাউজেন্ডস অফ কোর্সেস আর দেয়ার, কোনটা তুমি নেবে? সো দেয়ার হ্যাজ টু বি সাম গাইড গাইডলাইন্স। এবং এইচওডিস রা এবং কন্ট্রোলার স্যার তারা এবং অন্যান্য ফ্যাকাল্টিরাও তারা দেখে একটা কোর্স লিস্ট সিলেক্ট করে দেয়। ফোর অর ফাইভ বাঞ্চেস অফ কোর্সেস আর সিলেক্টেড, যে তোমাদের এই সেমিস্টারে এই কোর্সগুলো তোমাদের দেওয়া হলো, এর মধ্যে থেকে যে কোনো একটা তোমাদের করতে হবে। দ্যাট ইজ দিস ফোর কোর্সেস আর গিভেন টু ইউ, আউট অফ দিস ফোর অর ফাইভ কোর্সেস ইউ হ্যাভ টু চুজ ওয়ান। সেই চার পাঁচটার মধ্যেই কিন্তু তোমাদের করতে হবে। If you can do any number of courses in any semester, but for college countability, college সেটাকে count করতে হলে you have to take the course only from the notice given to you during the start of each semester. আমি তোমাদের একটা sample notice আমি দেখিয়ে দেবো। Okay?
Sir,
বলো।
Sir, I have a query regarding the degree offered.
Then this 20 points he or she must not require. Only 8 semester courses will be sufficient.
Okay.
ক্লিয়ার? ওকে, সো আমি আবার তোমাদের কিছু কোয়েশ্চেন নেব, লেট মি জাস্ট প্রসিড ফার্দার, আরেকটু কিছু আমি বলে নি, দেন আই উইল এগেইন টেক ইউর আই উইল টেক এগেইন কোয়েশ্চেন টেক কোয়েশ্চেন ফ্রম ইউ, ওকে? আচ্ছা, নেক্সট দেখো, দিস ইজ নর্মালি অনলাইন সার্টিফিকেশন প্রসেস, আই হ্যাভ শোন ইউ ডিফারেন্ট আইআইটিএস অ্যান্ড আইএসএস দে কন্ডাক্ট দিস এক্সামিনেশন, ওকে? এবার এখানেই আমি একটু বলে দিচ্ছি আমাদের যে হোয়াট ইজ দ্য প্রসেস। First, you have to take the course, enroll into the course, register in the course, the process, the website, I will all give that description there. So normally from SWAM, this is available in SWAM. So in SWAM, I mean, the portal that you will just type the course name and you will get the course there. You have to join that course. Now about the assignment, suppose you have taken an 8-week course, okay? 8-week বা 12-week ওখানে মেনশন করা থাকবে দ্যাট ইট ইজ অ্যান 8-week কোর্স অর 12-week কোর্স অর হোয়াট এভার। এভরি উইক দে পুট আপ ওয়ান অ্যাসাইনমেন্ট, মানে প্রত্যেক উইকে দে পুট আপ সাম লেকচার নোটস। সাপোজ দ্য কোর্স ইজ স্টার্টিং অ্যাজ ফার্স্ট অফ এনি মান্থ, ওকে? সো অ্যাট দ্য ফার্স্ট অফ এনি মান্থ, দ্যাট ইজ অ্যাট ডে ওয়ান, দে পুট আপ অল দ্য কোর্স হ্যান্ড নোটস, কোর্স ম্যাটেরিয়াল, PDF, PPTs, they all put up in that portal where you have registered, okay? Just mail er moto, email er moto dekhbe okhane sob course gulo they have already uploaded. Now you download, you can download those videos, lecture notes, PDFs, CDs, you can already download those as well as you can, okay? So end of that, go through the material and at the end of that you have to submit.
Your voice is breaking.
Apnar voice ta sir break korche.
Sir, can you please repeat whatever you said because your voice was breaking?
Oh, exactly, I will repeat. No issues. Okay, actually the weather is very foul, so the network is having some problem. No, dekho, course start day one, okay? And at day one they will put up some lecture notes, video notes and everything they will put up in that portal. You can go through the videos online or you can download the videos as well. Presentation, PDFs, everything you can download. Okay, you can download and store in your computer and you can see those things anytime if you want. Okay, now at the end of that week, মানে week-এর শেষে, you can see that they will put up a quiz or assignment. 10 questions will be there. Normally they are MCQ. Sometimes they are also, you have to write some answers as well. This kind are also there. So 10 questions are there. You have to answer that 10 questions and submit in that portal. So that assignment is submitted. Okay. So every week you have to submit one assignment. Okay. After the 8-week is completed, for 8-week course suppose, and for 12-week course, after the 12-week assignments are already submitted, they will give, announce one date for examination. Before that, you have to register for examination. I will tell you that later. So at the end of the course, you have to go for some examination, proctored examination. Dekho, ekhane ekta chobi dewa ache, the fourth figure, that is fourth quadrant figure. That is proctored exam. That means you have to go to their exam hall, prescribed exam hall, wherever your admit, whatever is written on your admit card. Eta examination jokhon tumra registration korbe, tokhon you will be given some options which is your first preference city, second preference city and all that. Okay, so final exam you have to go to their centers and you have to sit for that exam to get a certificate. Okay, so 5 certificates are required in this college for this 20 credit points. Now remember, you can do any number of courses. Course gulo korte kintu fees lage na, remember this carefully. To do these courses, to get the materials, get the videos and all these things, there is no charge. Okay, but for sitting in the exam you will be required to pay a fee of 1,000 rupees for getting that certificate. I will come to that later. So mainly 4 parts are there: registration, enrollment and all these things. Then every week you have to submit one assignment, then you have to go to the lecture hall at the end of the course, got the exam online, then only you can get the certificate. Okay. So this is the basic procedure. Now, how to do that? That is another important issue is that how to enroll and register and all these things. What are the points? Now, better everyone should have a Gmail account. Then this registration process will be done very easily and directly. And if you don't have any Gmail, then you have to log in into their account using some user ID and password. Then you can also do that. I will show you that. But better if you have some Gmail, then you can directly register in there or enroll in their portal. Okay. So preferably you have a Gmail account. Now then you have to enroll. Enrollment means that we can again to do to jinish, be very careful. Enrolling into a course. How to enroll? I will show. Enrolling into a course means you are intending to do that course. That is enrollment. প্রত্যেকটা কোর্সের কিন্তু একটা ডিউ ডেট থাকবে দেয়ার ইজ এ ডিউ ডেট ফর এভরি কোর্স এন্ড উইদিন দ্যাট ডিউ ডেট ইউ হ্যাভ টু এনরোল দ্যাট ডিউ ডেট উইল বি ডিসপ্লেড ইন দ্যাট কোর্স অলরেডি সো উইদিন দ্যাট ডিউ ডেট ইউ হ্যাভ টু এনরোল ইন ওয়ান কোর্স হোয়াট এভার কোর্স ইউ আর উইশিং ইউ হ্যাভ টু এনরোল ইন দ্যাট কোর্স উইদিন দ্যাট ডিউ ডেট যদি ডিউ ডেট ক্রস করে যায় ইউ ক্যানট এনরোল ইন টু দ্যাট কোর্স আমাদের কিন্তু উই আর ওনলি কোঅর্ডিনেটার্স But nothing is in our hand because, you know, these are already run by NPTEL, IITs and the SWAM. So nothing is in our hand. We will just coordinate it. But everything, examination, course, submission of assignment, evaluation of assignment, everything is on their hand. So we will just coordinate that this is your date within this date. We can remind you that within this date, you just enroll or register. But not beyond that. Even where is your exam venue, that is also decided by them. We cannot change the venue as well. Okay, because this is not done by our college directly. We are accepting the certificates given by the NPTEL authority. So governing authority is NPTEL itself. Okay, so we have no hand in exam venue, exam date, exam center, or whatever are their protocols. Okay. Now, enrollment should be done within that due date. So suppose 1st of March is the enrollment date, last date of enrollment. So you have to enroll within 1st of March. That means you have joined the course. Now, after you have joined, someone may wish that I will just complete the course. I don't want the certificate. I will just complete the course because I want to learn. Then you don't need to register. But if you want a certificate, that means 5 certificates we need for this college for to offer you 20 credits. So if you want a certificate, you have to go for the final exam. Jodi shudhu course ta korte chao, if you want only the course content, course videos and all that, you don't need to register, you don't need to go for the final exam. You can do any number of courses if you want. Okay. But if you want a certificate, you need to go for the final examination. And before the examination, there is any questions, anyone?
That was a noise, I believe.
Okay, so if you want to go for the exam, if you want the certificate, then you have to register. And final date of registration will be given in your course as well. মানে যখন তোমরা কোর্সটা দেখবে কি কি অ্যাসাইনমেন্ট দিয়েছে কি কি কোর্স ম্যাটেরিয়াল দিচ্ছে দেয়ার ইজ অলরেডি এভরি টাইম দে ডিসপ্লে দিস ইজ দ্য লাস্ট ডেট অফ রেজিস্ট্রেশন ফর এক্সামিনেশন সো উইদিন দ্যাট due date you have to register and pay fees of 1,000 rupees okay so if you want certificate you have to register as well and do this registration much before the due date because all over the country many number of students thousands and lakhs of number of students go for this NPTEL courses so there is a huge rush on that server so better not wait for the last date if you want to go for the final exam, if you want to get the certificate, you better register for the examination much before the final date. If you come to us that, sir, my registration is not occurring, there is a server error, my fees are not cut from my bank account, I cannot pay the fees, we cannot do anything. Okay? So better do the registration early, much before the final date. These are just for your information and for your betterment, we are telling you that, okay? Because we have already experienced many of these issues. Okay, then after you have registered, you have paid fees, that means you are ready for the final examination. Okay, you have to complete all the assignments. Marks distribution I will come to later, just after the slide. So you have to complete the assignments and submit the assignment every week. Jodi keu mone karo, I will not give the assignments, I will only sit for the final examination, that will again not do the thing, because there is marks distribution for assignment as well as for final examination. I will show you that. So you have to submit the assignments every week as well as you have to go for the final examination. And for some courses, there is another online examination which can be done in your home or college. Okay. So in some of the courses, there is assignment and only final examination. And some of the courses, there is assignment, final examination, as well as another very short examination, online examination, but that can be done through online portal in your home as well. Okay. So that will be given in your course. Then you sit for the final MOOC online examination at exam center. That is important. Final examination cannot be done through your home. That has to be you have to go to the exam center, sit for the exam and acquire the minimum points from that exam. I will tell you about the points. Then if you pass the exam, only if you pass the exam, then link for the certificate will be given to you by the mail. Because for enrollment, you have to have one email, that is Gmail, I am preferably telling you. In that mail through which you have enrolled for the course, in that mail, the link of the certificate will come to you. You just click on the link, the certificate will be downloaded. And remember very carefully that download the certificate very quickly, that is within a few days, before the link is deactivated. Once the link is, because after some days, they deactivate the links. So sometimes they deactivate the links. So, or maybe some server issues or something arise. So before that occurs, you should just download the certificate. It will be in PDF form. Just save the PDF in your computer. Just upload it in your email. Have it in your pen drive, hard disk, wherever you can, and get a printout of that and keep it with you. Because once the certificate is lost, if you have not downloaded the certificate, it will be really difficult for you to recover the certificate. Okay, so once the link is given to you, just download the certificate quickly, get a printout of that, save that PDF to your drives in your computer as well as cloud drives, save that PDF there, and you are just sit, relax, that you have the document with you. Then this document needs to be submitted, that certificate needs to be submitted to college. You will hand it over to me through your CRs, and I will hand it over to Partho sir because he is the controller. So that is our part. So you need to submit that certificate to the college when we will be giving you the notice that whatever certificates, whatever courses you have done, submit the certificates to college. You will just submit the certificate to us. Okay. So save that certificate carefully. Now, this is how you register for the course. I will just give a brief about that. Just in Google, you search SWAM and it will come swam.gov.in, SWAM Central. Okay. Then you click on the SWAM Central, then this portal, it will open. Then here is some search box. Dekho course catalog likha ache and there is some search box. Do you please just write the course name here? Type the course name here. Okay. So you just log on to swam.gov.in. Okay, swam.gov.in, you go there. Then this portal will be opened. Then in that portal, after this course catalog, just here, in that course catalog. এখানে দেখো একটা সার্চ বার আছে, অল রাইট, দেয়ার ইজ সাম সার্চ বার, সো ইন দ্যাট সার্চ বার ইউ জাস্ট রাইট ইয়োর কোর্স নেম, ওকে, জাস্ট আই উইল শো ইউ, জাস্ট ইন দ্যাট সার্চ বার হিয়ার ইউ জাস্ট রাইট দ্য কোর্স নেম, হোয়াট এভার কোর্স উই উইল বি অফারিং, আই উইল শো ইউ ওয়ান নোটিস অ্যাজ ওয়েল, যে কিভাবে কলেজ থেকে নোটিশটা দেওয়া হয়, যে কোন কোর্সগুলো ইউ নিড টু, দিজ আর ইউর অফার্ড কোর্সেস, আই উইল শো ইউ দ্যাট অ্যাজ ওয়েল। সো এখানে কোর্সটা লিখবে, যেই কোর্সটা তোমার প্রেফার্ড, লেখার পরেই এই পাশে যে সার্চ আইকনটা আছে, ইউ জাস্ট ক্লিক অন দ্যাট সার্চ আইকন, ওকে, এই সার্চ আইকনটায় ইউ জাস্ট ক্লিক হিয়ার, ওকে, হোয়েন এভার ইউ ক্লিক অন দ্যাট সার্চ আইকন, সাপোজ আই হ্যাভ রিটেন আর সফটওয়্যার ফর এক্সাম্পল, ওকে, I have written R software there and press the search button. Then suppose this introduction to R software, this course they have already shown me that this is the course you are searching for. Then I will click on that course. Just anywhere here, you just click on that course. Whenever you click on that course, then this details of the course will be, this page will be opened. This is the course page, okay? Now course layout is already there, je week 1 e ki porano hobe, what will be in week 2, week 3, week 4, all these are given here. Who will be teaching that course, that will also be given here, okay. What is the date of your start of the course, end of the course, exam date, everything is mentioned in that summary part, everything will be given there, okay. Now what you need to do, দেখো এখানে জয়েন বলে একটা অপশন আছে, ওকে, জাস্ট আন্ডার দিস পিকচার দেয়ার ইজ এ জয়েন অপশন, ইউ জাস্ট ক্লিক অন দ্যাট জয়েন, ওকে, হোয়েভার ইউ ক্লিক অন দ্যাট জয়েন ইট উইল টেক ইউ ইনসাইড দ্যাট পোর্টাল, ওকে, নাও হোয়েভার ইউ ক্লিক অন দ্যাট জয়েন ইউ উইল বি আস্কড টু লগ ইন টু দ্য সাইট। এখানে দেখো একটা অপশন রয়েছে, ইউজার নেম অর পাসওয়ার্ড, you can use the username password as well, or if you just have a Google account, Gmail account, then click on that Google, ekhane just Google e click korbe if you have a Gmail account, and it will directly log in. That's why I'm telling you, if you have a Google account, Gmail account, you don't need to do anything else, just open that Google in any other tab, Gmail ta khule rakhbe je kono arakta alada tab e, mane Gmail ta the login thakte hobe, so if you have that, just click on that Google. Whenever you click on that Google, it will be directly logged into that system. Okay? Ebar jokhoni tumra system e dhuke jabe, mane eder portal e dhuke gele, that means you have to now enroll. Ebar definitely kichu details dite hobe, shegulo ami ar ekhane show koreni. Jemon you have to give your name, phone number, email id will already be there, name, phone number, college name, like this, in which year you have passed class 12, all these things, these few credentials you need to give there. You just insert all the credentials and save and go to the course. Just click on the save and go to the course, that will be at the end of this credentials. Whenever you have filled up all this name, your college name and all these things, then you just click on the save and go to the course, and you will be taken to the course. That means your enrollment is done. You have enrolled for the course. This is only for enrollment. Mane, you wish to intend to do the course. Okay. Now, if you complete the final examination, this kind of certificate will be given to you. Now I am coming towards the marks distribution. Okay. This kind of certificate will be given to you. Dekho, ekhane dekho duto segment royeche. Definitely name, course name, these are all given, and this is the total marks you have completed, your image will be there, okay, no college name and anything will be there on here. Now there are two segments in marks, online assignment one mark and proctored exam in another mark. Dekho, online exam is out of 25 and proctored examination is given out of 75, okay, and this is an 8-week course, it is given here. Now I am detailing that both the marks are essential for getting the certificate, both assignments you have to submit as well as you have to go for the final exam. Now, just I will come to that slide just a minute later. Before that, again, I'm recapping. Now, it is free to enroll. You can enroll for any number of courses. But if you want a certificate, you have to register and pay fees within the due date for proctored exam. And by person, you need to go there at the exam centers and you have to go for the written, online examination at their centers. Okay. And exam fee optional. Optional means if you want a certificate, then definitely you have to go for this exam and give a fee of ₹1,000. Okay. And that is what is presently there. It may vary depending on their criteria. And normally the dates and exam, that is exam normally occurs in two schedules, first half and second half. First half is normally within 9 to 12 in the first half. And in the second session, you have from 2 to 5 p.m. Another session is there. Tarmane, I can tell you one thing. I will tell you a few words after I have completed that PPT. Those are tips for you, especially some important things that you need to remember. Now, if you register for two courses, suppose in your first year, there are two courses. And someone is saying that I will complete both the courses in the second semester. Then you have two courses. Now, suppose you are choosing two courses in such a way that both of their exam dates are same. But you can still manage that because whenever you opt for those two courses having the same date of exam, and if you enroll through the same email ID, remember one thing, you be very careful. Whatever course you just join, join with a single email ID. When ekta email ID kintu use korbe. Don't use different email IDs for different courses. Be very careful. Use a single email ID to join or enroll whatever number of courses you do. Okay. Now, whenever you are registering for exam, and the both the exams are on the same date, and you are enrolling through, registering through a same email ID, they will see that the same person is opting for two exams on the same date. They will give you one exam in the first half, one exam in the second half, or they may also give you the choice to opt for first half or second half, or they do it accordingly, automatically. So enroll or register through the same email ID or whatever number of courses. And if you opt for two courses having the date of exam same, then you can go for both the courses, give exam for both the courses in both halves. Okay. But if you go for three exams and three exams are on the same date, it is not possible. So two exam you can give in one day. Another exam you have to choose in such a way that its exam date is some other date. Exam dates they declare earlier in the first while they declare all the courses. That is, exam dates are fixed. Normally they do not change. Okay. So while registering for the course, if you have three courses to complete, why three courses I will come. If you have three courses to complete, then you have to arrange it such a way that maximum two exam falls in a single day. And the third exam must be on any other day. Three exams in a one day, it is not possible. Okay. Ebar ami tomader marks distribution tai aschi. Then I will discuss why I am talking about three exams in one day. Okay. Dekho. Calculation of score. This is done in a way that 25% marks is allotted from all the assignments you submit. Tamane assignments er upor ache 25 marks and remaining 75 marks is on the proctored examination. Exam score is out of 100 and it is scaled into 75. There is 75% marks is taken from the out of 100 marks. Okay. And the final score will be average assignment score plus final exam score. Money 25% will be taken from these assignments. Thoro 8 weeks, the money 8 assignment you need to submit. So out of that 8 assignments, whatever marks you have scored, 25% of the marks is taken from the assignment. And 75% marks is taken from the final online examination at their centers. Okay. Now the pass criteria is very, very rigorous. That is very strict. They are about it. Assignment score and final exam scores must be more than equal to 40%. Meaning you have to score 40% individually from assignment as well as from their final exams. এবার দেখো আরেকটু ক্লিয়ারলি বলি, অ্যাসাইনমেন্ট ইজ অন 25 মার্কস, 40% অফ 25 ইজ 10, দ্যাট মিন্স ইউ হ্যাভ টু আর্ন মিনিমাম 10 মার্কস ফ্রম অ্যাসাইনমেন্ট, অ্যান্ড 75 ইজ আই মিন দে আর স্কেলিং ইট টু 75 দ্য ফাইনাল এক্সাম, 40% অফ দ্যাট ইজ 30, সো ইউ হ্যাভ টু স্কোর 30 আউট অফ 75 ফ্রম দ্য মেইন এক্সামস. If you add this to that becomes 40. Okay, so 10 out of 25 from the assignment and 30 out of 75 from the main exam you have to score. Suppose someone is scoring 25 out of 25 in the assignment, but 25 out of 75 in the main exam. If you add this to 25 from assignment and 25 from main exam, together is 50, which is more than 40%. But still he or she will not succeed the exam. Can you? Because 25 out of 75 is not qualifying. Make it very, very clear in your mind that you have to score 40% in each category, both in assignments as well as in semester examination. 40% individually is must. I'm getting higher number in assignment and in the main exam I'm not doing well, getting less than 30 out of 75, that will not do. Again, someone is not submitting any of the assignments or one or two assignments only, but in the main exam he or she is scoring 100 out of 100, that is 75 out of 75, that will also not do. Okay, so you have to keep balance in both of them. In each category you have to obtain minimum 40%. Okay, and they will only issue e-certificate. Now no hard copy certificate come to your home by your postal address, only online certificates are given. Online certificates are given only if you qualify. Someone is sitting for the exam and telling that I have not got the certificate, that means you have not qualified. If you do not qualify, you will not get any certificate. Only if you qualified in both categories, both assignment more than 40% and main exam more than 40%, then only you will qualify and get the certificate. Otherwise, you will not. Okay. Now, this is a typical notice given by the college. I am giving you as an example. This kind of notice will be offered to you every semester. Okay, suppose this is offered to the first semester students. That is, in first semester, another point I want to mention, in first year you have to do two courses, first year I'm talking about. Now in the among these two courses there are two categories only for the first year: science and engineering group and humanities group. Two groups are there. Now these two courses we have already talked about, these two courses must be one from each group. One from each group you have to take. Dekho tomader ki ki option dewa ache in science and engineering groups. Suppose you are given introduction to R software, joy of computing using Python, and problem solving through programming in C. These three courses are offered to you from the engineering group. And soft skills and developing soft skills and personality, these two are given for humanities group. That means you have to take any one from here, one from here. That is, any one from this group, another one from this group. If you are saying that I will take both R software and Python, you can do that, but only one will be counted. Make it very clear to you. One from each science group and one from humanities group will be counted. But you can do any number of courses. Every time I'm saying that, you can do any course, any number of course, anytime. But for college countability, one course has to be from science and engineering group, and one course must be from humanities group in the first year only. And from second year onwards, there is no such groupings, intergroupings. Okay. From second year onwards, you will only be given a single list. But within that list, you have to take one subject. Eta ekjon question korchilo. I am telling to all of you that in college, we will only accept the certificates for these courses only, which are given to your notice, which are notified by the college. Only those certificates will be accepted. You are doing some other courses which is not listed here, but we will not take that certificate. We will only accept the certificate which are notified in college notice. And every semester, at the beginning of the semester, you will be getting one such notice. Okay. And normally I am telling you three more things, that when you register for the exam, three options come there. Apart from your name, phone number and all these things, three other options come there. Just I am telling you, you should do this. There is an option of credit transfer. You should put no there. What is credit transfer? In some remote colleges, sometimes what happens that due to lack of faculty or due to lack of something, infrastructure and something, these courses are taken as a part of BTEC course. Okay. In that case, they accept the credit given by the certificates. But we are not taking that. We are not doing that actually. We are only taking the certificates for honors degree. This is not part of your BTEC. This is only an additional part to BTEC, which is honors. So credit transfer, you put no there. Share information with college, you have to put yes there. Okay. And another point is there. Is college a part of local chapter? You should put yes there, because our college is a part of local chapter of NPTEL. So you put yes there. Now, whenever you put yes there, there is a drop down menu, and from the drop down menu, you can easily find our college name, Government College of Engineering and Ceramic Technology. Okay. So credit transfer, no. Share information with college, that is definitely yes. And college is part of local chapter, make it yes. Then select college name from the drop down menu. Okay. And just coming back, when we issue this notice, in that notice, the date of exams are already mentioned. You can also verify this from the SWAM portal. These are all given. So date of exam is already mentioned there. So you should choose the date of exam in such a way that maximum two exams can fall in a single day. If you have three exams to do, then you have to take it accordingly. Now I just tell you a few things, then I will take your questions. Why I'm telling about three exams or four exams in a day? Why it happens? Suppose someone is now studying in third semester of any stream. In first year, due to some problem, some major problem, he or she could not sit for the examinations. This examination means is this online examinations, could not complete the course. That is, first year two certificates are not with him or her. Okay. So two courses are pending. Now she or he is in third semester. So second year course is already due. That means second year take ekta course korte hobe, and first year duto course kintu already tar due ache. Or maybe he or she is unsuccessful in those previous two courses. That is, 40% criteria is not met. That is, certificate, he or she has not obtained the certificates. Okay. Then two courses are pending from the first year, and one course is pending in the second year, which is the allotted course in the second year. Now, if he or she wants to complete all the pending courses, that means first year two courses and second year one course, then he or she has to go for three exams in one semester. Okay, that is second year exam, one exam, and first year two, backlog kind of exams. Okay, so there is a question of 3 exams he or she has to complete in this second year. Now what he or she can do? He or she can go for 2 backlog examination of the first year in the third semester and clear the first year courses, and in the fourth semester he or she can do the second year allotted course, because this kind of notice will be issued to you in all the semesters. Okay, third semeo pabe ki ki ekta option pele, fourth semeo option gulo pabe, maybe the same options, maybe some different options. Keno different? Because I have already told you that these are all run by the NPTEL and IITs, SWAM and all this, so we have no control which course they will offer. So it may be so that third semester e tomader dhoro tinte course chilo offer kora hoychilo college theke, mane they have offered and we have selected those 3 courses from their list. Maybe that in fourth semester none of the courses are running now, maybe then we shall choose any another set of 3 or 4 courses and give you as a part of second year course. So anyone can do the second year course in third sem as well as fourth sem. Okay, so if you have a backlog, you can clear the backlog courses in any subsequent semester. Mane second year e uthe tumi first year er backlog course jodi kichu thake, you can clear that. In third year you can clear the backlogs of first year and second year. In final year you can clear the backlogs of first year, second year and third year, just like the semester. But our advice is always to clear up the courses in each semester properly. Mane first year ekta chesta koro first year e complete korte, second year ekta chesta koro second year e by third or fourth sem, and like that. Otherwise there will be pressure on you because these are addition to your semester courses. Semester e already ekta pressure thakbe tomader porashonar, in addition to that jodi ei backlog course gulo jodi add hote thake, it will be a great pressure on you. So try to complete that courses within due date. Second thing, ei course gulo kokhon hoy? They do not normally run all throughout the year. They have a session. Normally the session is from July or August to say September or October. This is one session. Another session is from January to say April. That is, these 2 sessions are in synchronism with your 2 semesters, even semester and odd semesters. Previous year a pandemic er jonno there were several several things happened in the previous semester, so I'm not going to that. But the normal schedule is one is from January to April, another is from July to October. These 2 sessions they normally run. Now I am coming to your part, only for your part. You have already joined now, which is already September. They have, NPTEL has already completed all those courses almost. Some of the exams are also completed. So there is no scope for you to take these courses in your first semester. So what lies on you? First year, both of the first year courses, you have to take up in your second semester. That means when next January to April session comes in the next year, 2022, and you will in second semester, in that semester you have to take both of the courses. Both of the courses means one course from engineering group, this is very important, that is one course you have to take from science and engineering group, another course you have to take from humanities group. There is one course each from each group. Okay, in normal time it doesn't happen, because in normal time the admission is during August and you take time to take up the courses in the first semester as well. But this time you cannot do anything else other than taking the courses in the second semester. Okay, so in second semester you have to take both the courses, one from each group. It will be notified in January. You will receive the notice, check out the notice, and whatever course you like, you just take the course. Okay, one from each group. Okay, and try to complete the course by second semester. And if anyone becomes unsuccessful, or in that exam date you have some serious problem, you cannot go for the exam, then you can take the course as a backlog to subsequent years. You can clear it up in the second year or third year like that. Okay, but try to avoid these things unless these are absolutely unavoidable. Okay, now I am coming to all of your students that if you have any queries, or I am also asking other senior teachers and Partho sir as well, that if I have missed any point, you can please add to it, or if the students have any question, you can ask.
All of the honors sir, honors question like advantage আছে সেটা একটু বলে দাও না গো।
হ্যাঁ, এটা basically দেখো, this honors has been introduced in 2019. Okay, Partho sir, আপনি আছেন তো এখানে? মানে সো উই ডোন্ট নো আফটার ফোর ইয়ার্স হোয়াট উইল বি দ্য ভ্যালু অফ অনার্স, বিকজ অনার্স ডেফিনেটলি ইজ অ্যান অ্যাডিশন টু ইয়োর ডিগ্রি. তো our advice is better to have the honors degree along with your BTech, because BTech with honors definitely has some extra value to your degree. Tai to sir, apnara bakira sir ki bolen ektu add kore den.
Ha, definitely.
In normal BTech degree they are earning 160 credit, whereas in honors degree they are having 180 credits, so 20 credits more they are earning, and these courses add value, nothing else, add value to the other courses which they have studied in their normal course of study, because these courses just augment their knowledge in different aspects. Like they can take different technological subjects as well, management courses or some sort of quality courses like that, quality management, HRD management, or business financial management. Then some off departmental courses like they can take some data science courses, anything they like, they can choose any of the courses being offered consultation with the HOD or you, particularly Alok sir. You can take any courses approved by the department, so that it doesn't become very tough or way different from your normal courses study. But in general, you have to take a course which is not being taught normally in your normal BTech courses of study. That should be a little bit different. Otherwise, you won't gain anything. Only other than taking that course, you won't gain anything. So you should concentrate on the courses being offered, should consult with Alok sir. In consultation with the HOD, you can take the courses, any of the courses you like. So it will add value, more value to your studies. That is the only thing contemplated.
Alok, Shweta Rajok has written something in chat. Could you please answer it?
So I'm just stopping, isn't it?
তো প্রেজেন্টেশনটা স্টপ করে দাও।
ওকে স্যার, ইউ হ্যাভ ইট।
নাউস দা হ্যান্ডআউটস, ভিডিও লেক, ভিডিওস লেক, অল পিডিএফস সেন্ড উড বি অ্যাভেইলেবল ইন আদার মান্থস লাইক ইন নভেম্বর ডিসেম্বর, সো উই ক্যান টেক দি এক্সামস ইন দি গিভেন সেশন বাট ক্যান প্রিপেয়ার ফর দেম ইন দা ক্যাপস। নো, ইট ইজ নট লাইক দ্যাট। Actually, these courses offered by IITs, mainly offered by IITs. They have got a particular time when the courses are on, the registrations are on, and then you can enter into that. So in a space of 2 to 3 months, you have to take the course, and then they these videos are uploaded in that period only, not throughout the year. So you have to register for the course. Registration is free, but when you have to give the examination, there's a fee being charged, that is 1000 rupees for appearing in the exam. So without giving the fee and giving the exam, you can't earn the credit. But anyone can attend any course. NPTEL course is absolutely free. Anyone can attend the course. You can attend simultaneously two or three courses. So you can judge which one you are to take, or you can gain knowledge. Anytime you can take any course being offered, but in a stipulated period of time, not in any period in your free time. When your semesters are not running, in that period, it's not that. Would I make it clear?
Exactly, sir. You have correctly pointed out. Exactly, sir.
So that is all published in the NPTEL website. It is given when the courses are starting, what will be the courses offered. So there is no standard guideline and each year all the courses will be offered. It's not like that. So every semester they change it, go on changing, a little bit of differences of courses. It's not that also that when a course is being offered this year, it would be repeated next year. It may not get repeated. It is also so.
Sir, Shushobhan Roy has also written.
And that's why, sir, we actually, in consultation with the HODs and controller, we actually need to
can
prepare.
Can from other platforms like Coursera other than NPTEL? Yes, you can take. Yeah. Yes, you can take, I think. Alok, you can guide them.
Sir, Partho sir may tell it a better way, but as far as I know, that NPTEL are accepted here. Partho sir, can you please add to it?
Coursera courses accepted?
Sir, if we put them in the bucket, then obviously it is accepted. But we have connection. We are the local chapter of NPTEL coordinated by IIT Kharagpur.
Okay.
So that is why we are following the NPTEL course only. So basically, if we put the courses from Coursera into the bucket, then we can accept it. But it is not in general practice in our college, sir.
Right. Sir, how the credit score would be counted if I get the certificate, I will get 4 credit points. 4 credit points means, you can get, if you pass the exam, you will get points out of that. Yes. You can answer it.
Alok, could you please repeat the name of the website as asked by Aniruddha Mukherjee?
So I just want to add that if you have to take minimum.
If I get the certificate, will I get 4 credit points?
Exactly, sir. You can get, but minimum 8-week course it should be. But when preparing the notice, we keep an eye on that aspect as well. That is, we notify only those courses which are minimum 8 weeks duration.
8 to 12. If it is less than 8 weeks, some of the courses are there of 6 weeks, you won't earn 4 credits out of that.
Six week course,
you can get 3 credits. And yes, some are 2
exactly.
Credits also. So you have to have a course of minimum 8 weeks duration.
We not for those in our notice as well.
So
normally, you know, notice
the website. Can you please repeat the name of the website?
Yes.
NPTEL. In Google, you just write NPTEL. Automatically, it will search out the website for.
Or you can also go for SWAM. SWAM.gov.in. SWAM. SWAYA. SWAM.
SWAYA.
Someone has written already. SWAM.gov.in. That is.
Students, one more thing. Here. In your normal BTEC degree course, what I have told you that there is, say, for example, mathematics course of 4 credit points. Okay.
No,
so
12-week course will be having only 4 credits.
Yes.
So there is no more
credit. If you pass the exam, 4 credit points. If you fail the exam, 0. So it is like a binary system. If you pass the exam, you are producing the certificate, 4 credit points. No in between. Okay. Whether you are obtaining marks in the range of 90% or above, or in the range of 80%, that is no matter.
It doesn't matter.
Exactly.
This question, the 12 weeks or 8 weeks doesn't matter because some of the course contents need more time. So that's why they have categorized as 8 weeks or 12 weeks. less than 8 weeks course means it is giving rise to 3 credit course, not 4 credits. So 8 to 12 weeks. Some of the courses are 8 weeks, some of the courses are 12 weeks. It doesn't matter. Exactly. In 12 weeks course, you won't earn more than 4 credits.
Exactly. Sir, I just want to add one thing. Someone may think that if 8 week and 12 week both are earning 4 credit points, so why should I go for 12 week course? But sometimes it happens that a 12 week course is easier than an 8 week course.
Yes,
so
yes,
sometimes
yes.
12 week course, because it takes longer time, but go for exams and earn some points. Okay. So it is up to you, whatever it
is. It is advisable not to unnecessarily go for tougher courses. It doesn't add anything.
Exactly.
Only thing, it will bother you. So you can choose a course in consultation with Professor Alok Mukherjee so that he can suggest you some of the courses very lucrative and which can add value, as well as it can give you earn you more credits, those credits easily, so that it's not very tough. And I don't think you will have any difficulty, because in first year, first and second semester, you won't have much of the theoretical courses. Only three to four courses, I think, being taught. The credit points, total credit points is 17.5 and 18. Whereas in following years, following semesters, you have to have much of the theoretical load. So you won't have any problem in first year in earning four credit courses. I don't think there will be any problem. So how
sir?
Many hours we have to spend per
sir,
week?
Sir, can I ask a question?
Yeah.
Yes, please.
Sir, apart from the courses that have been recommended by the college in the second semester, suppose I want to do another course that have been conducted by the IITs. So can I do that?
I can do that always. You can
so,
always
sir,
do that.
When I do that course, will I be able to put that like as an extra point in my CV?
That you can, yes, you can write in your CV always. It will not be reflected in your mark sheet though. You know, mark sheet only 4 plus 4, 8 credits in first year, 4 credits in second year, 4 in third year, and 4 in fourth year. That means 20 more credits will be added up and been shown in your mark sheet here. But always in your curriculum vitae, always you can write whatever you have done extra to this. So if you have attended any Coursera course, any course from MIT, any foreign course or any other thing, that can add value and you can add up to your CV.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Yeah. When we have to start taking the courses, you have told. Okay, this year that Professor Mukherjee has told, this year I don't think any more time is left for taking the
yes,
course
sir.
In 21. So
yes,
from I think February, March of 22, the courses will be offered, and you remain in consultation with Professor Mukherjee, and he will suggest you what to take, when to take. Only thing, due to this pandemic, this has happened, that the admission is pretty late this year and last year also. So
yes,
in that 6 months, in your second semester, you have to complete these 2 courses. Otherwise, it would have been distributed in 2 semesters.
So, can I ask a question?
Yes.
Yes.
So, actually, the thing is, all the courses, like, it will include live classes or like all our recordings.
You can,
video recording.
You can listen to the recordings. Yes, those are recorded things.
Okay, it will be like a video live class or firstly
yes.
When it will be recorded, right?
Recorded.
Okay,
it is recorded courses.
Actually,
yes, sir, it's recorded.
If it would be a live
it
class.
It is recorded classes, but generally in your announcement section, the faculty concerned do 1 or 2 live session to clear your
yes.
doubt. There is
yes,
an
yes.
Announcement session, announcement section in the, if you join
and
a course, you will find the announcement
yes.
portal.
Yes, doubt
there will, you will find notice when the teacher will be live to clear your doubts. After, say, for example, eight-week course, so after 4 weeks, the faculty will do 1 live session. And before, after ending the course, another live session. Okay. So you may get those chances.
So if that that live session collapses with the college timing, so it will be a problem, right?
They generally do it in the evening. They generally, I have completed okay. many courses from there. So they generally do it in the evening.
They never do it during the daytime.
They have okay. also classes in IITs, right?
Yeah. Sure.
It's normally Thank from you. 6 or 7 p.m. like that.
The exam time is announced at least just after the starting of the course, at least 6 weeks back or 6 weeks ahead, the exams are taken. So students are pretty aware when the exam is going to be held. The date is announced pretty earlier. And you have to proceed with the course with many assignments. They give assignments. You have to submit the assignments regularly on a regular basis. They are assessed and then the final exam. So even if you regularly produce the assignments, unless you appear in the final exam on the stipulated date, certificate is not awarded. You have to deposit 1,000 rupees per course for that. And this particular idea is has come from All India Council for Technical Education. This is not our mm-hmm. syllabus. This is actually our syllabus is only normal BTEC syllabus of 160 credits. But this is adopted from the idea of All India, as per guidelines of All India Council for Technical Education. And as per their guidelines, we have adopted the NPTEL courses in our studies. So that is not fixed, it is variable. Every year, depending on the particular courses being offered, anyone can have the liberty to choose any course in consultation with the teacher.
So like the exam center will be in the IITs or?
No. In Kolkata only.
Okay. In Kolkata only, okay.
Yeah. Whatever you know, the center you give the choice. So there are certain examination centers. I think
in West Bengal they offer Bankura, Durgapur, Siliguri,
yes.
Hooghly also. There are many cities.
Many
Barasat.
Barasat, yes.
Many centers they offer.
Many centers.
And one more thing I wish to add that since it is related to our college curriculum a bit, BTEC with honors ultimately, so we take care about these exam dates and all, and I can assure that from the college there will be no collapse, exam date collapse, right? Like if you have MOOCs exam on that particular date, you will not have midterm or semester end exam. We take care about that.
That is always adjusted.
That is always adjusted, right, sir? Rituponno, sir, one more thing. If I miss anything in during the academic regulation part, you wish to add, sir?
It's okay. I don't think you have missed anything.
Okay. No, you have covered everything.
Thank you, sir. I have a query.
Yes, who's it?
My name is Akash Sharma. I am from IT department.
Yes, carry on.
My query is that if from the college two courses I choose for to each section, if this is from 6 week course, but I am not assignment section, I am getting less percentage below 40%, then I am not getting the certificate, then I have to enroll again.
Yes, not assignment. You have to pass the final exam. Assignments, if you are not progressing well, they may give you some sort of, you receive mail that your progress is not good, you study well, or you consult the videos that has been uploaded, you concentrate on that. Your exams are nearing. So these type of notices will come. Your assignment immediately would be evaluated. Any kind of doubts would be cleared. And as Patu sir and Alok sir has told, that there will be some doubt clearing sessions, live session with the teacher. Sometimes within that 3 months period, maybe two times or three times, he will be appearing to clear out your doubts. But you have to pass the exam. So my advice would be always, not to take a very tough course, way hard course, like which like in course of your study in first year and first semester and second semester, it will not be that you know, difficult, because you don't have that much of load in your theoretical courses of study, very less. But in second year onwards, when you have more of courses, but that time you have to have only one course. In two semesters, only one course. Maybe in one particular semester, if you feel pretty loaded, you may not take that. In the next semester, you can take. But the courses should not be similar to the courses of study in your BTEC. And it can be an interdepartmental course also. You can take an environment course. You can take a management course. You can take a computational course, anything which you like. They offer pretty varied types of courses. But you have to pass the exam for earning the credit. Otherwise, you can attend 2-3 courses, and the course which you feel more comfortable, you can register for the exam for that only. That you can do. People generally do that.
Okay, thank you, sir. Thank you.
Any more questions?
Because, you know, after getting admission to an engineering degree, you won't feel that much of pressure in first year and second year, though the courses are new and you have already progressed well in your higher secondary studies. You have studied this physics, chemistry, maths well, and entered into the, appeared the final joint entrance examination, passed it, and then came here. But some of the courses will be new to you, so you have to study, but not highly pressurized, what I feel, in first semester and second semester. Am I correct, Partho and Alok? Am I correct? In first and second semester,
yes, sir.
Very pressurized.
No.
Exactly.
Absolutely.
They're pretty, you know, relaxed. I think you can take the course if you regularly attend classes. Religiously attend classes, it won't be at all difficult. So you can take many of the courses from NPTEL or Coursera, whatever you like, mainly NPTEL, varieties of courses you can try out. You can register for two, three courses parallelly, because in following semesters, in third, fourth, fifth, sixth, you will have 6 to 7 courses in your normal BTEC study. So you can try out from the first semester itself to take some 2-3 courses and then register for the exam for 1 or 2 courses. So if you take, so you have to take 2 courses, you register for 3 courses at least, so that it is 3 normal BTEC course and 3 NPTEL course. And finally, you take 2 exams from the NPTEL course. Can we take courses from Coursera? The same question has been answered. Generally, it is a trend to take NPTEL courses because the packets are available. As on date, Coursera courses have not been taken by any student till now, as far as my knowledge goes. Am I correct, Patu?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Hello, any more questions?
No, sir.
Okay. Partho, Professor Shen, Partho and Alok, so I should end the session now, asking Supriyo to end the session. One request, Partho to and Alok, would you please stay with me tomorrow, because there's a message in my mobile that there may be an electrical disruption due to some electrical fixation in the from 12. I don't know if it'll happen or not. So I request you to please stay with me.
Obviously, yes, sir. I will be with you.
3 times power cut in between. 3 times power cut.
So you had power cut.
Yes, power cut, and with my Jio, I could not listen properly.
I'll try to continue in my mobile.
Mobile data cannot support this type of WebEx platform. My mobile data.
Now, tomorrow there will be an introduction with the students from 11 to 1:30.
Tomorrow, and what are then from program? What is the program tomorrow?
Tomorrow, Thursday, introduction to students along with their parents. There are more than 30 students left. Some have not joined at all. And then next there will be a lecture by Professor Kollan Kumar Chattopadhyay, who has been recommended by Nilesh. And next is Sri Orijit Ghosh. On, couldn't hear you, sir.
Professor KKC.
KKC, yes.
Yes, I know him.
And then Sri Orijit Ghosh, he is also recommended by Nilesh. Professor KKC will be from 2:30 to 3:30 p.m. And then Orijit Ghosh will be from 3:30 to 4:45 p.m.
Very good, very good.
Partho are all of the thakho ek to bhalo hai duto session hai.
Let's see, I'll try. So full time may not be able because other some of the commitments are there. But okay. Having a stable connection, I may be there also. In the morning, because in the morning, principal sir will also be there.
Yes, principal sir will be there in the morning. Nilesh will be there in the evening. I have asked him. I'm requesting Partho and Alok to also stay with us. And tomorrow I have exam also.
Sir, don't worry, we'll be there. Sir,
okay. My exam is from 11:15 to 12:15. Okay.
Let's stop the recording.
Yes, please stop the message. Yes, please stop the recording. And stop the show also.
You can leave now.